and through which campaign you got that lead, that is what we will define here. See, connecting the lead to the campaign. So this is what will give you a clear and idea of how successful your campaign was. How many leads did you get from there, and how many of those were converted? Okay. So based on that, you can understand whether the campaign was actually successful or not. So this is the campaign product demonstration. This is the phone number. Save it. So whatever leads you receive or the inquiries that you receive will be stored in the leads tab. Got it? So we have campaigns, we have leads. Now let's move further. So this way you might have received a few leads. Now you start calling these leads after the campaign is over. You give these leads to your sales people and you ask them to start calling, right? The moment these guys have started calling, let's say they call this guy Ajay Kumar, okay? Your sales team calls him and this person says that, see, when they start calling the leads, what happens? There are two possibilities. One, the information provided is not complete information or it is incorrect information. Let's say Ajay Kumar has not given his email ID or phone number. There is no way you can contact him. Or the phone number or email ID that he has given is incorrect. You are not able to reach him on that number. Okay, that's a number which is not reachable, which does not exist. Possibility, I mean, you guys keep on doing all these things, a lot of times we do it. In fact, a lot of times we go to some place and we are asked to fill in a feedback form or something and we do not provide our phone number there, right? So we just want to make sure that these guys should not reach me and should not call me and all that stuff, right? So that is there is a possibility that you have a need, but the contact information that you have is not correct and you are not able to reach that person. Okay, or even if you are able to reach that person, the moment you call him, he says, "No, no, I'm not interested at all." There is a possibility. The other possibility is that you contact this person and he says, "Yes, I raised this inquiry and I have this requirement." So let's assume that we call this guy Ajay Kumar. And he says that, yeah, exactly, you are correct. We need laptops, but I am a sales manager, so I cannot take a call on from which vendor we want to buy. You'll have to talk to our procurement head because buying decisions they will take. I'm just aware of the requirement that we have, but for selling the laptops or for us to buy the laptops, our procurement head has to decide on this, right? Now, what do we do there? Now, Ajay Kumar has given us one more contact. He says, "Contact Vijay Kumar. He is the procurement head at Wipro." Okay. Now, where do I go and store this information about Mr. Vijay Kumar, who is, who works in the same company at a different designation, and I need to store both the information, right? So here, if I go and create one more lead for the other guy, then what will happen? The problem will be that these two leads will be different, okay? But I want these two things to be connected. Okay, so in that case, what I'll do is, and since they have kind of because the company is showing interest, I also want to track a little extra information about the company. Let's say the industry of the company, how many employees they have, right? So, I mean, the moment you see that the company is showing interest in your product, you start to gather a little extra information about them, right? Where do they have branches, how many employees that they have, so that you can, you know, plan, you know, how much you can sell to them and all. So now this is where the difficult situation comes, that you talk to one person in that company, Wipro. You are trying to sell to Wipro, you are talking to Ajay Kumar, and he says, no, I can just tell you that there is a requirement, but you have to contact another guy, Vijay Kumar. You call Vijay Kumar, he says that, okay, fine, there is another guy called Srinivas. He is one person you will have to talk to. So you might get into a situation where you need to store 3-4 people, 3-4 individuals' name and phone numbers in your database or in your CRM, right? So in this kind of a situation, we will need to break the information into two pieces. In the lead, what we are doing, in the lead, the same record, we are storing the name of the individual as well as company. So company information and the individual information is coming in the same record, same entry. But what I need to do now is, I need to make a, you know, separate record for company, okay, and a separate record for individual, okay. So what I do need here is, I need to make an account called Wipro, and I need to create two contacts under that account, which is Ajay and Vijay. Got it? So we need to have this account and we need to have these two contacts, Ajay and Vijay, there. Clear on this? So this is what we have to get into.
Excuse me, sir, can you repeat this?
Yeah. So what we need to do here is, because we have multiple contacts or multiple, you know, individuals which need to be tracked for Wipro, we need to break this into two tables. In one table, I will store information of the company, which company? Wipro. Other table, I will store information of individuals, Ajay and Vijay, right? So this is what we are going to do. How will we do this? From the lead button, you just need to click on convert. So you already have a lead called Ajay Kumar. The moment you got to know that, okay, you need to include one more person here. You just need to click on convert. Okay. The moment you convert a lead, it breaks the lead into account and contact. Now the company information, in the lead we had information of the company as well as individual. Now the company information part is moved into account and individual's information is moved to contacts. So it by default creates an account for you once you convert the lead. So account name is Wipro. Now you see, you can put all other information related to account, type of the account, industry, revenue, billing address, the website of the company, ownership, how many employees, SIC code, everything can be mentioned here. Okay. And the contact information goes into a contact, which is called Ajay Kumar. See, it comes under it. Now you can maintain more details about the contact also, like the title, department, birth date, mailing address, language, assistant, email, fax, mobile, whatnot, everything. Moreover, you have a scope of adding more contacts. So as of now, if you look into this, we have one account called Wipro, and we